We also have to start looking at our balance of payment. And when we talk about the balance of payment, clearly I think our export base is, you know, is a very narrow export base, and we also have limited export markets. We do not trade with our neighbors. SAARC is redundant and so is ECO. I think, you know, most of the economic blocs basically trade with each other, whether it is ASEAN or it's European Union or NAFTA, but we don't trade with each other. One third of our, you know, exports go to US, another one third to EU, and the rest to the rest of the world. We basically have to now diversify and also create more export surpluses, you know, and in this I would say the agriculture being our backbone, we should create more productivity, create more agrarian surpluses and export. Then people talk about, you know, poverty. And I think we have been following the policy of trickle-down effect. Then let's have economic growth, and the trickle-down effect of that economic growth will basically remove poverty. For God's sake, those 50 million Pakistanis now deserve better. We need to have a targeted approach to remove poverty through skill development, through, you know, their health insurance, through other mechanisms. And I think this basically has become essential. Otherwise, it will create, you know, more and more disparity and create the kind of, you know, fundamentalism which we are seeing on the streets now. Moving on, the two major areas which create employment in our country, one is agriculture. This is where 65% of our, you know, population lives. And the other is manufacturing and trade. Unfortunately, in the agriculture sector, we have thought that this is God's gift to us. We don't have to worry. And every year, you know, there'll be rains, there will be produce, and that's it. And we have fallen behind. There was Mexipak many decades ago and nothing else. Today we produce probably 25-30 mons an acre, and there are countries who do 80 to 100 mons. Sucrose content in our sugar cane is around 8.5 to 9. China is around 17. Countries like Egypt and others, they produce much, much more cotton than we do. In 2001, we produced 12.5 million bales and so did India. Today, India is 33 million bales and we're still at 12.5 million bales. We got to just basically start working on improving the productivity of our, you see, agriculture sector. Clearly, you know, the different elements like, you know, water. How to utilize water. We basically still use flood irrigation. There is no drip, there is no, you know, people have gone to cloud irrigation. Would you believe that we basically, the Abiana, we just collect for our, you know, maintenance of our water resources is 20% of the actual expenditure. We price our water as if, you know, it is free. So I think we have to develop, you know, water resources, but then we'll have to price the water, you know, properly, and then we'll have to utilize the water properly. We have to work on better seed and fertilizer and mechanization. There is no warehousing here. It's so surprising that we have a commodity exchange, but there is no warehousing. If we have, you know, world-class warehousing, we could have warehousing receipts, which could be, you know, basically traded on the commodity stock exchange. But we haven't developed, and frankly, government after government has been saying, planning, but, you know, nothing has been done. And we have obviously very low on, you know, kind of value addition. I mean, let me take, you know, the example of milk. 20% of the current milk production is lost due to poor infrastructure facilities. As a result, Pakistan, despite being the fourth largest milk producer, is a net importer of milk. other issue we have is obviously the energy crisis. We have to reform our energy sector, and it's my belief that we must have an integrated energy ministry or integrated autonomous body, which looks after the entire energy kind of landscape of Pakistan. Electricity, we basically, the optimal mix should be hydro, coal, wind and solar. And guess what? Apart from hydro, which is going down as a proportion of the total production, we are using the most expensive, medium, which is oil. And for us, even gas is not a long-term kind of solution. We've got to develop the other, and we have the third largest coal reserves in Thar, 175 billion tons. It can produce 100,000 megawatts for 110 years. So what are we doing about it? We can produce around 55,000 megawatts on our hydro, around 50,000 through the three wind corridors, and there's some estimate that we can produce a million, because of the solar, because we get sunshine. But all this, of course, means that we also need to involve, the private sector in development of these resources. And government alone cannot do it. We might as well basically, catch the bull by the horn. And there is a 25-year plan, 15-year plan, 20 up to 2025, which was prepared by us. Us means all the, specialists in the energy sector, private sector energy specialists. And it's, gathering dust. I think we should take a look at it. What it said was that there are estimates that Pakistan has 150 trillion cubic feet of gas, 40 to 60 billion, barrels of oil. I've just told you about the coal. So we should have a concerted plan, to invest, and we should involve the private sector. When we talk about the industrial competitiveness, we are not only fragmented, we lack scale, and we are low on value addition. If you look at textile, which is the biggest industry we have, for every 1 million bale gets converted into $1 billion. India does too.